It's day five of the Project Edward road trip, and we're in sunny Surrey with Simon Turner, who is campaign manager for Driving for Better Business. Simon, tell me about Driving for Better Business then.
Driving for Better Business is a government-backed Highways England programme, which is aimed at helping employers in both the private and the public sector to do three things effectively. First is to manage their work-related road risk. The second is to help them control the associated costs that come with that. And the third is to help them improve compliance with current legislation and guidance. And that's encapsulated in our vision statement, which is that everyone who drives for work should do so safely, efficiently, and sustainably. And the way we work towards that is by sharing case studies and stories from people who do it well to demonstrate the business benefits that can come from good management in this area.
What do you mean by business benefits?
Well, quite often when you're running a fleet, often the typical costs like fleet insurance or fuel or servicing and maintenance costs, they just get marked down as the typical costs of running a business. But many businesses don't realise the impact that poor management can have on those costs. You know, you can't blame the driver, it's the poor management of those drivers. But it therefore follows that, you know, good management in this area is the key to unlocking those business benefits.
Give me an example then of how, give me an example of how significant those business benefits can be.
Well, a good example is a company called JMHC Logistics, which is the latest company to get involved in Driving for Better Business. They've seen over the last year or so a significant improvement. They've reduced their maintenance and servicing costs by almost 70%. They reduced their fleet insurance by around £1 million. And a lot of the management processes around improved work schedules and that kind of thing have led to or contributed to a decrease in their fuel spend of around £80,000. So yeah, that's really significant benefits for any business. They run a fleet of about 700 vehicles, but it's good management that's done that.
Well, if the benefits are that good, why doesn't everybody do it?
I think often it falls into one of two reasons, really. The first is probably a lack of awareness that there is actually something here to manage. Many businesses don't understand the size of the risk and that there actually is something for them to keep control of here. The second is that even when they do understand that there's a risk that needs to be managed, quite often they don't have the resources or the experience to manage it well. And that's really where Driving for Better Business tries to step in. As far as awareness goes, we do our best to reach new groups of business managers through a range of channels to try and raise awareness and help them understand what their responsibilities are. And then we have a range of resources and online tools which can help mitigate the second factor of the lack of experience and expertise in what to do. So, you know, what we really try and do is support businesses on that journey from awareness to actually doing something about it.
Has coronavirus had much impact on what you do, Simon?
We're seeing quite a big impact, yes, and specifically on transport mix. We've seen a massive increase in the number of vehicles required, for instance, for home delivery. A lot of those companies are thriving and really trying to grow, but that brings its own problems in terms of work schedules and policies, so companies really need to be on top of that. And again, in terms of sort of vehicle maintenance, where we know a lot of companies, a lot of vans and cars miss their MOTs over the lockdown. So I think companies have really got to be on top of that with the changes in fleet mix and the changes in the types of journey that their staff are making.
What do you recommend an employer does next then to find out more, to get involved and to hopefully start saving?
Well, we've got a range of free online tools on the Driving for Better Business website that can help. The first is an online gap analysis, which will show you where there are any gaps in your management processes, whether that relates to company procedures or vehicles or drivers, whatever that is, and it'll give you a report explaining why each particular bit is important. You know, the second thing is take advantage of the resources we've got. We've got a huge library of, again, free resources, which will help fill any of the gaps that report identifies.
Simon Turner, thank you very much.
Thank you.